Today on Be Something Wonderful, talk to yourself this way and watch your dreams come true. I am your host, Tom Karen, and this is the Be Something Wonderful studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Creators, good morning and welcome back to the studios of Be Something Wonderful. Later on this morning at 9 a.m. Pacific time here in the U.S., we're going to have another live event on the Be Something Wonderful membership channel. Be sure to join us. I'm going to answer your questions live on the chat, as well as the emails that you've been sending to us. If you're a member, join us. If you're not a member, check out the link below. I want to talk about an email that I received from one of you, a very powerful creator. And I know of you from some of the Facebook comments that our team has been sending me, really brilliant comments, and as a powerful creator in your comments on the channel. Well, this email was a beautiful demonstration of creating your dream reality with your inner speech or your inner talking or your story. She changed her story. She refers to a specific person video that we did a few weeks ago. I think it was in early November. I'm going to talk about this video today as well. And I've linked it in the description. But again, it's not necessarily, today's lesson's not necessarily about manifesting a specific person. It's about manifesting your dream life. And she demonstrated this. Well, let's get into it like we never have before. Here's her email to me. Your videos changed my life. I started watching over a year ago, but your last SP, or in other words, specific person, that's what SP means to those of you that are not familiar, specific person, manifesting a specific person, a relationship. Your last SP video was the one that shifted me. This is a subscriber. I think we received this email around November 4th, around the time, the night, the evening of when that video was sent out. It was sent out, the video was posted earlier in the day. And the name of that video, and it's linked below, are you struggling to manifest a specific person? Do this. And of course, as all of my videos are not just about manifesting a specific thing or person, it's about creating the life of your dreams, about manifesting anything. Here's what she said in her email. We're going to cover this today. I had it all wrong. Interesting. It reminds me of the quote that I often point to from the 2002 movie, Solaris, which was a remake with George Clooney as Chris Calvin, right? George Clooney referring to, remember in Solaris, they were orbiting a planet called Solaris, a planet of light. And this planet of light created this instant manifestation of whatever the contents of your consciousness, right, would be manifested or projected into your experience immediately. Very powerful movie. But he says, I was haunted as he returned to Earth, right? Or that what he thought was Earth. The 3D linear experience, right? Remember, it's all the same. It's all one. So you got to see the movie. I was haunted by the idea that I remembered her wrong. This is his wife, his wife, that died by suicide. Right, they had all these problems and she died by suicide. I remembered her wrong and somehow I was wrong about everything. This is what the subscriber, I had it all wrong. When we remember it wrong, right? Her insights, like today's video, are not just about manifesting a specific person, but rather making all your dreams come true. And you're gonna see this today like you never have before. Very powerful, let's get into it. Remember, we're going to get to her comments specifically towards the end of this video because that's how they'll fit in. Remember, you talked yourself into your current life experience or your reality that you're experiencing, that you're living, right? You talked yourself into your reality and life experience that you're living right now. So why not talk yourself, who you really are, that being that you are, into the life of your dreams? Right? You have been living under the roof of non-fulfillment. In that idea that I am not yet that which I desire to be. Now, just say the word. You can tell that I'm referring to the story in Scripture, right? The metaphysical meaning of this story, where Jesus, as your I am awareness of being, heals the centurion's servant, right? And in that story, it says, but just speak the word, just say the word, only speak a word. Remember, the centurion says to Jesus, your I am awareness, I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof. I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof. Hear this, come under my roof. But just say the word and my servant will be healed. And it says in that verse that the servant was healed in that very instant, at that very moment. Wow. In other words, what does healing mean? It means to see yourself and others in your world as whole, complete, fulfilled. It's moving to the version of you and the version of reality, in the version of events where you're already healed. Very powerful. Just say the word. You've been living under the roof of non-fulfillment. That's why in Scripture it's so powerful when the centurion says to Jesus, I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof, but just say the word. In other words, non-fulfillment is created by me. That unworthiness is created by me. This is the centurion recognizing that actually he is absolutely worthy and fulfilled and complete. Remember, you're playing all the parts in this case. Jesus, your I am awareness, the servant, the centurion, it's all you. I've been living under the roof, the illusion of non-fulfillment, of unworthiness, of not being that person that I know that I am. But I'm just gonna say the word now. I'm gonna tell the story of fulfillment no matter what the conditions are. Wow. Only speak a word. That's in the New King James Version. Only speak a word. What's the word? I am. Yeah, it's two words, but it's the word. I am. It's the word of God. But speak the word only in King James Version, but speak the word only. And then in the NASB, it says, just say the word. Just say the word. Just speak a word. Speak the word only. Wow, the message is clear here. Never been clearer. Stop trying to fix, to change, to ignore, to get rid of the old story, the old script, the reality, the version of you and others that you don't prefer, right? Stop living under that roof of non-fulfillment, trying to fix that illusion of unworthiness, of non-fulfillment. Just choose again. Just say the word. Leave it. There's nothing to do with it. You give it solidity and reality every time you focus on it, every time you try to fix it or ignore it or change it or get rid of it. Right? In other words, stop living under the roof of non-fulfillment. Stop talking yourself into non-fulfillment. You can talk yourself into anything, but why are you talking yourself into non-fulfillment? This is powerful, right? And I know spiritual teachers say ignore circumstances, but it's not really even about that. You don't have to do anything with them. Just be indifferent. You are all of it. Be like the centurion, Lord, I'm not worthy for you to come under my roof, but just say the word, just speak a word, speak the word only. My servant will be healed, whole, complete, fulfilled. And the servant was healed in that very instant, in that same hour, it says. Stop waiting and wanting to be who you want and desire to be, and just say or speak the word, tell the story, not from under the roof of non-fulfillment, but how you know yourself to be, how you would like things to be. This is powerful. You don't have to do anything with the old story or script or manifested circumstances or versions of you in reality that are unwanted or not preferred. You don't even have to ignore them. Simply choose again, even while you're experiencing them in physical experience. You are reality. Tell a new story. Imagine and assume your dream life. Say the word. Just say the word. But every time you ask, well, how do I do it? Why is this happening to me? When is it going to change? Where is my stuff? Where's my love? Where's my SP? Where's my money? That keeps you living under the roof of non-fulfillment. And what the centurion says, I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof. Forget that. Stop wanting and waiting and wondering and hoping from fear and doubt in a story of I am not yet who and what I desire to be. Stop all that and tell the story. We're going to show this today like we never have before. This is a masterclass that this particular subscriber presented, her own shift. We're going to show this. So stop trying to fix the problem of non-fulfillment and unworthiness. That just puts it there. You couldn't have that experience of unworthiness or non-fulfillment unless you were absolutely, unconditionally, limitlessly worthy and fulfilled. You couldn't have that experience. It's just pointing you back to your utter worthiness, to your utter fulfillment. Those old stories of I am not, stop, you don't have to live under that roof anymore. Right? The question is who, and the answer is I am. The answer is you. I am. This is what the Be Something Wonderful subscriber said on the specific person video that is linked below that was released a few weeks ago. That's very powerful, right? Everything about the video, this is what she says. Your words, enthusiasm, the golden sunset. We did this from the island of Bonaire. The topic you covered, the metaphysical metaphors you used, everything created a profound shift in me. And keep in mind, I know this of this particular subscriber from her Facebook comments. Very powerful, very tuned in and aligned with the teachings, the metaphysical teachings. Really, really, really knows her stuff, embodies it, but yet, still had a profound shift. Wow. She demonstrated a masterclass in instant healing, because that's what it is. That's what healing is, when you instantly shift to that knowing of who you really are. Instant shift of identities and realities. We're going to show this today as we're doing. This is what she says, and I drew a diagram to kind of demonstrate what she was saying. She may even comment on this video. I hope she does, and give you a little bit more insight. She says, I was trying to live in a script without having changed my identity, right? Still believing in separation, 3D circumstances, while affirming a reality that did not belong in that script. She was affirming her new reality, her desired reality. This had to do with a specific person giving her attention, not being so busy, right? Loving her. She imagined this. Do you see how when we imagine something, we're not just imagining something from a standpoint of something in the future. We're imagining it in all time. As we imagine that reality, we change the past, present, and future. I've never shown it like this before. So look at this imaginal scene. Yes, you're imagining yourself with that specific person. And what she's saying here, I was trying to live in a script without having changed my identity. She was trying to imagine that, right? Affirm that new reality from that I am knowing, while still being in the identity of the old script. They did not belong, what she was affirming did not belong in that script, that script, it doesn't belong here. That's why the centurion said, I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof. Well, I'm in that I am not yet that person I desire to be. Well, I'm in this old script trying to imagine, trying to affirm that new life, but believing that this is my reality. I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof. Wow. She got it. I was trying to live in a script, right? This new one, without having changed my identity. Still believing in separation, 3D circumstances, while affirming a reality that did not belong in that script. It's a different script. You don't change this script. You don't alter this reality. That's what fate means. each script, each reality, each possibility, each potential of all that is, has its own fate. You don't change any fate or reality or version or script. You choose another one. Do you see it? You have infinite choices of fates, but any one fate can't be changed. That's what fate means. But you have infinite choices. So stop trying to change that. It doesn't belong in that script from that identity. Right? That goes on and on and on. All that is not all that is, unless all that is can exist. You can't eliminate, delete, or change any part of all that is, or it wouldn't be all that is. All that is means that script exists. But you don't have to keep living under the roof of that script. You can move to that new script, that new reality. But if you're believing in this one, you don't get there. Right? You feel unworthy. I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof. But if you just say the word, if you know that you're shifting to this new reality, that you're not changing this, that you're not altering it, that you're not trying to make any change here, that's how you shift. And I'm going to show this today. Even though she was affirming, imagining, assuming, all of that, her preferred reality, she was doing it from the old identity in the old script. This. And this is what she says. She says it. These are her words. I was telling a story about how my SP was always busy, an incredibly busy person. So he had little time for me. I always put the focus on my specific person, as if believing that it was up to him to decide how our relationship would unfold in my life. In other words, she was still living under the roof, in the script, in the reality of unworthiness and non-fulfillment. Believing, hoping, imagining that it changes here. But that doesn't change. You move to the new one. So nothing was wrong with her processes of imagining and affirming. It was where what she was doing. The only question is, who are you? I'm lost for words. Who are you, right? So excited about this, right? Who are you? You're not this. Let that go. So this is powerful. So as we go on here, this is what she said. This is her discovery. I'm going to diagram this for you, her movement, her shift. It was all me. It is all me. It was all me. And then she emphasizes, it is all me. Just say the word. Now she's speaking the word. She's only saying the word. She's imagining it from everything is her. She's all identities, all realities, all possibilities, all scripts, all film roles, all images, all thoughts and feelings are within her. She gets to decide from here. Not from that what she believed are the manifested circumstances that go on and on, but a new script. She moves to a new possibility that creates that horizontal linear experience that he's always had time for her, and he'll always have time for her, and they'll always be in love. Wow. She says here, adds to this, I do not need to see the events unfolding in 3D to know that I have shifted. That's powerful. I do not need to see the events unfolding in 3D to know that I have shifted. Why? Because needing to see them, you're believing you're in a script that needs to change, that these events need to change. She's instead knowing that they're always changing, that she's already there, and that wherever she is, that new reality is. She's the proof. She's the shift. You, the past, present, and future, is always shifting and changing and manifesting in every moment now. Wow, that's powerful. And here, and remember in the movie Next that I quoted from with Nicolas Cage, right, where he could see 2 minutes into the future. Here's the thing about the future, he says, but remember, I'm saying this is really a reference to reality. Here's the thing about the past, present, and future. Here's the thing about reality. Every time you look at it, it changes because you looked at it. And that changes everything else. It changes everything. You are reality, you're all of it. You're entangled, you're holographic, you're non-local, as the scientists say, right? You're entangled with everything because you are everything. It's holographic, meaning you are all of it. Wherever you are at all of you is. Wherever God is at all of you is. It's non-local, you're everywhere, you're everything. You're all of it, you're not this, right? You're not this. You're this, where it's changing. Every time you look, it changes. That's powerful, right? So that's why in Moses answering God, and that I've talked about in scripture, Moses, Moses, here I am. And the servant was healed at that very moment. That's what it says in the centurion servant. At that very moment, she shifted. And here's what she says, really powerful. I am expecting, but not from the old identity, not from waiting for things to be different. I'm now the version of me that receives the attention and the time she wants. And it has always been that way. It's always been like that. How did I not see that? I now get it. I had it all wrong. Wow. Do you see it? She's no longer waiting here, hoping, wanting things to change, imagining it, but believing in this manifested reality. And now she's in total expectation that everything's always unfolding from within her. In every moment, the past, present, and future is changing. She just expects it, expects things to unfold from within her, from her I am awareness, from her multidimensional identity. Wow, that's powerful. I had it all wrong, and somehow I was wrong about everything, like in the movie Solaris. I get it now. Wow. That's how to talk to yourself. Talk to yourself and watch your dreams come true. I am your host, Tom Karen, and this is the Be Something Wonderful studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Creators, thank you. Thank you for being with me. Thank you for liking and sharing and commenting on the videos. Thank you for being part of our Facebook group, The Ambassadors, at facebook.com/groups/BeSomethingWonderful, for joining us on Instagram and Twitter at Tom Karen, TikTok at Be Something Wonderful, anywhere on social media at either Tom Karen or Be Something Wonderful, you can find us, and for being part of the membership channel. In less than an hour, we're gonna launch our next live event, answering your questions right here from the studios of Be Something Wonderful in the Western US, 9 a.m. Pacific time. I'm going to be answering your questions, chatting with you, and answering questions that you've been sending to us at info@besomethingwonderful.com. Be sure to join us. If you're a member, join us. If you're not a member, check out the link below. The video will then be available exclusively on the membership channel with the other 22 live streams already available for you to watch, and dozens of more videos are on the membership channel. And we have another one queued up, another lesson queued up for the membership channel coming out over this weekend, the next day or two. So stay tuned. With great love, with great light and infinite gratitude, this is Tom Karen here in the studios of Be Something Wonderful. Until next time, we'll see you soon.